Brett Craigmile works with a greenhouse full of weeds. The University of Missouri graduate student in plant sciences is looking for the best combination of herbicides to kill these weeds.
It's always a war on weeds. Plants are so adaptive and they can constantly change and mutate and develop resistance. It's just a constant battle.
This is water hemp. This is our biggest weed problem in Missouri.
MU Extension weed scientists are working with a herbicide called 2,4-D and mixing it with other herbicides to combat resistance. 2,4-D is commonly used on dandelions and in corn and soybean fields. But farmers can't use the herbicide once their crops start growing. That's why MU researchers are working with Dow AgroSciences to engineer corn and soybean plants that can tolerate 2,4-D. Researchers identified enzymes that are resistant to the herbicide. Once the enzymes are placed in corn or soybean plants, the 2,4-D attacks the weed, not the farmer's crop. But MU weed scientists say these new technologies will be a long-term solution only if farmers use smart weed management practices.
You know, a lot of growers will look at the 2,4-D resistant soybean technology and they all think it's going to be the next silver bullet, just like Roundup Ready crops were. If we have that mindset, we're gonna lose those technologies too.
Bradley says the number one thing is to apply herbicide mixtures with different modes of action, meaning different herbicides that attack weeds in different ways.
As we've got to move away from spraying just one herbicide over and over, get another mode of action out there that will control that resistant weed species.
Rotating crops keeps weeds off balance and combats resistance. The MU weed scientist says farmers must not wait until herbicides stop working or rely solely on new technology. If they do, it will cost them more in the long run.
If we don't take it as a tool in the toolbox that has to be part of an integrated program, we will fail at all these new technologies that come down over the next couple of years.
From the University of Missouri, I'm Kent Faddis reporting.